Alright, hey, welcome back again to my channel. This is Rob, and we're going to do the Walking Dead, kind of the first half of the season review, mainly because I'm not going to do reviews of the 7th and 8th episodes that I missed because of technical and other problems that were going on at the time. So I'm just going to kind of give my consensus so far as far as what I think of this first part of the season. And, you know, this, to me, is a very divisive season. There's a lot of people that love it, and there's a lot of people that hate it, it seems. And I'm one of those people, I guess, that, you know, I don't want to be one of those that falls in the middle or whatever, but, I mean, I feel like, this season started out, like, super strong, like, super good. And up until, like, through episode 4, I want to say, episode 4 or 5, I was really, like, vibing on everything. There were a couple of things that, you know, like, everything that you might just kind of be like, eh, but, you know, from the jump, you know, the attack on the sanctuary, the way that they kept going after the outposts and all the different things that people were going through, like Rick, you know, killing the dad and finding the baby. Full spoilers, by the way, if you haven't watched the first half of season 8. You know, you've got the loss, Aaron's boyfriend gets killed. We get a bunch more red shirts. I mean, that was one of the problems I think a lot of people have, was people talking about just a bunch of red shirts getting killed. Even Aaron's boyfriend, Eric, to me, was pretty much a red shirt. Not everybody considers it that. You know, like if a character like Tobin were to die, he's red shirt, but not red shirt. Like, he's been around long enough, he's had enough lines where he's kind of a supporting character like Eric was. But, you know, when you're not focusing on that, if you don't kind of give somebody focus, at least once or twice an episode, you know, like they do the mainstay, you know, you're still considered a red shirt. So people were complaining that, you know, basically just faceless or nearly faceless people were getting killed off. And that's, you know, that's valid. But, you know, let's face it, in this group of people, like, they're playing it so, anybody that dies at this point, people are going to be upset about, like, really upset about. So, before we get to, like, you know, what everybody already knows, I mean, with Carl getting bit at the end, you know, that was supposed to be this big shock of a thing. And I guess if you were living off social media, as far as, like, if you like this show a lot, and you know, go to social media and go to YouTube and look at reviews that talk, like Travis Chan too and stuff, who talk about The Walking Dead, you know, every day, and inform you all the time, or, you know, just links on Facebook and things like that, you knew that this was kind of coming. I mean, they told us, like, a long time ago, and, this was just part of what I felt like was the downward slide of this part of the season. I really started to get bummed out with, you know, the direction that they were taking it towards the end of the first half, just because, you know, they had plans, and everybody just suddenly, like, started to just make up their own plans, you know, just to kill, you know, saviors like Daryl and stuff. You know, just things that were, you know, seemed to be kind of out of character for somebody like Rick to just, he's going to talk to the trash people, right? And he knows Daryl's got his own ideas, and yet they're going in separate directions. You'd think Rick would be like, man, I can't leave him alone. You know, he just tried to take those guns, and he was planning on going to that place and killing everybody. But I'm going to go talk to the trash people who have betrayed us on, you know, and you know, shot me and all this other crap, and it's all hinging on Rick's plan working, yet you just let, you know, this huge thing go away that you know is a problem. Things like that were starting to, like, were gnawing at me, you know. That whole trash people section, you know, these people, when you see what happens, you know, what happens, like, and the plan, you know, to run the walkers in there just creates a reason for them to escape. You know, and so when Rick shows up with the trash people, of course they're going to go away again. What was the whole point of that? If they knew that this was where it was headed, why send Rick to the trash people? Why not send Rick to Oceanside instead of having that story be Enid and Aaron? You know, if Rick was going to go on a road trip and be far away from Alexandria, why not make it going to Oceanside and getting the women there? You'd have a better chance because they actually know what it's like to fight the Saviors and lose to the Saviors. No, let's go back to the dung heap of people over there who we can't even trust. Just kind of dumb storytelling, in my opinion, like when you had other options and other places to go to. And again, with the whole Carl thing, like, such a huge mistake and such a huge, like, wasted opportunity when, you know, everybody that talks about it, that, you know, some people that talk about this show actually do read the comic. Some people, they pretend that they read the comic when they really just read a blurb on Facebook about what happens in the comics. I love that. You know, that there's so much that they had, you know, to give Carl to do later on. And I always said, you know, if you want to get rid of the kid who plays Carl and there's a time jump, just recast him. You know, age him up and recast him and get a better actor, somebody that, you know, people actually like as an actor. You know, I know Chandler Riggs has his fans, and I do like the character. I just don't particularly care for his acting, so him dying for me isn't a deal breaker or anything. It's just a real kind of messed up way for the way that the show is headed. When you know how far, if you, you know, when you read the comic and you know how far they have to go with this character and they decide to kill him off, it just kind of feels like either they know something we don't about the future of this show, like, you know, time-wise, like how many more seasons it's going to go, and that's also been brought up on other people's websites and YouTube videos, or this is just really, like, they think it's going to, you know, like, shake things up. You know, or maybe they, you know, just really didn't like Chandler Riggs. I don't know. But it just still seems pretty weak. I mean, what are they going to do? Give Carl's part from the comic to the kid that Carol's hanging out with? No, let me tell you something. I don't think anybody gives a crap about that kid. And him taking over for Carl's storyline would just be a punch in the face to hardcore comic fans and pretty much fans of Chandler Riggs. So, I should talk about the things I liked about this. Like I said, like, if you've watched the first, if you've, you know, seen this whole thing, I'm still sticking with the first four or five episodes are pretty good. It kind of feels like up until when the tiger died and Ezekiel walked into his little stage play area, I feel like that was like the last really, you know, great episode. There are good moments in just about every episode. I just feel like I could just feel like a kind of a shift in the way things were going. I just was going until that thing, that reveal, like, Carl's gonna die. Because I really liked, like, his whole interaction with Negan. That was really good. But I mean, again, part of my underwhelmment is probably from reading the comics, knowing that Alexandria was going to get firebombed. It didn't change the fact that it was interesting to look at. And I know that they probably change things so comics fans can be like, ooh, I didn't know you were going to go in that direction. But sometimes that works and sometimes that doesn't. And here, I guess I was just a little underwhelmed. I did like the Negan-Rick fight. That was pretty cool. Although pushing Rick out the window and then having to just basically not go after him, or Rick not going back after Negan, was kind of weird. And it also kind of felt like the season 6 finale, where it was building up to the Saviors taking control, you know, of Rick's group. It felt like we were headed back in that direction again, and it still kind of does, but I'm sure that's going to be a quick turnaround, so I'm not as worried about that. I really feel like Carol was underutilized. She seemed to just be there to... Either, I don't know if she was supposed to learn something from Ezekiel, or if Ezekiel was supposed to learn stuff from her. But she really didn't get to do much. I mean, that's, you know, the part where she ninja'd in and took out those guys with the guns and stuff was pretty cool. But I mean, and, you know, whenever, in that episode, she did get to be a bit of a badass, you know. But that's really all she's kind of done. And so you have like somebody like her, and you really didn't do much with her, except for being able, like, telling to be there to be the voice of reason for Ezekiel, telling him to get up, you know, stand up, and, you know, look at me, I'm still alive, and I've had to fake it till I make it, you know. So I hope that they use her a lot more in the next half of the season, and I would also hope that they address the Daryl issue of how, you know, again, he does things that cause the consequences are bad. Like, and I know that you can say that maybe these things were going to happen anyway, but, you know, starting with, you know, when he punched Negan and then Negan killed Glenn and Daryl blamed himself, like, Daryl did something great, rash, and then, you know, something bad happened. Now, you also have, like, and he blamed himself for, like, a long time until Maggie's like, it's okay, buddy, you know. And then he decides that because he was captured and he was, you know, treated so poorly by the Saviors, he needs to kill them all, and so he's gonna just not follow Rick's plan and crash a car, like, let vengeance take over, crash a car in there, and wait for the walkers to come in, and then we're gonna come back, and we're gonna wait and see what happens. We're not gonna wait there and see all this happen. No, we're gonna run the truck in there, and we're gonna leave. And we're just gonna trust the few snipers that are there that it's all gonna go as planned. Really, not well thought out, because that gives them the motivation. Eugene has to come up with an idea to get them out of there, and he does, and they're out, and now everybody's suffering again because of something Daryl did. So I hope they address this, because it's pretty serious, in my opinion, to be that, you know, maybe everybody is forgiving now, but I mean... I don't know. I digress. I love Daryl, but I just feel like this is a, you know, the character tone, like, was this where they were going the whole time? So, I really wish that this would be the end of the trash people, but I doubt it. It was pretty ridiculous what went on with Eden and Aaron. I mean, I realized that the grandmother was kind of the one keeping them from fighting, but damn, you know, just blowing her away without any kind of warning. Like, that was a really not well thought out subplot. You know, I'm starting to not trust Scott Gimple. The thing is, he's been so good and so solid that, you know, you have to give somebody some leeway, you know. Like, he's the coach, kind of, I feel, of, like, this team. And, He may, you give somebody some leeway when they've been winning for so long, but a few more mistakes like this, and I think it's time for old Scott to take a hike, unless, again, this is where they're headed, and they plan on ending the show sooner rather than later. A few other things, with the killing and not killing of the saviors with the characters like Jesus, that got really beaten into the ground pretty hard, to where I just was like, fine, just you, let him, somebody's gonna betray somebody, or somebody's gonna get the drop on somebody, and all these saviors, it's all gonna blow up in our face. And I'm still waiting for that to happen. But I do feel like there's been some pretty poor decisions made in, from a show running standpoint. But all in all, still really good season. Compared to what people complained about last year, we were seeing quite a bit of some kick-assery from our group. But it's war, so, we're going to take hits on both sides. Anyway, oh man, I'm about to sneeze. If you like this video, please hit the like button. We have 34 subscribers. We are one away from the 35 I wanted to get before the end of the year. Just to really quickly though, this was a good season. I can't wait for next season to start, or the next half in February. There's going to be plenty of things to talk about up until then, including whether or not Andrew Lincoln will be back after this year because of his contract being up. So, don't want anybody to think I didn't like this season. It started strong and ended weak to me. I don't think the finale was as big a deal to me as it is for other people. I have a high tolerance, I guess, for craziness. And, sometimes I wish I hadn't read the comic book so I could be as surprised about everything as everybody else. So anyway, again, like, subscribe, comment, let me know what's going on, how you feel about Walking Dead. Let me know what you want to see me review. Tomorrow is Star Wars: Last Jedi. It will have full spoilers. Because I feel like at this point everybody's spoiling it all over the place. It's hard for me not to watch videos or go on social media without worrying about it getting spoiled for me. So, anyway, this is Rob. We will see you on the next video, and you have a great night.